Hi, my name is John Truss and you're on the Solvers channel for Hitachi cooling and heating professionals. Welcome, I'm here to help you solve your questions. But first of all, let me tell you about the zero harm policy we follow at Johnson Controls Hitachi to always stay safe at your work environment. You can contact Hitachi for further information. In today's video, we're going to see some of the steps we have to take to prepare the Sigma VRF unit or another unit from the VRF range after the installation has been completed, so that everything is ready for starter when the service technician arrives. To do this, we will need a nitrogen bottle, a pressure regulator, gloves, goggles, a manifold gauge, vacuum pump, vacuum gauge, and a set of spanners. Let's get down to business. In this video, we are going to show you how to adjust the dip switch for the indoor unit and the outdoor unit, a leak test, a vacuum test, charging this installation with refrigerant and the power supply. As you know, a VRF system has to be seen as a whole, and it consists of 1 to 4 outdoor unit models depending on the capacity and the necessary indoor units. In the outdoor units, you have to adjust the refrigerant cycle address, which is something like the equipment surname. And then for each indoor unit, you have to adjust the refrigerant cycle and you also have to set the address of the unit, which would be like the first name of the equipment, so that when the outdoor unit gives them an order, they know who they have to obey. If we have one outdoor unit, we only have to adjust the cycle. But if we have several outdoor units that form a group, we have to adjust the main unit, telling it that it is the master, and tell the rest of the units that they are secondary units. How do we tell them who is master and who is secondary? By setting the dip switch for main and secondary units. If it is a two-pipe system, you will have to adjust the dip switch to indicate it, because if you don't, the 30 error code might be displayed. Don't forget that Hitachi VRF units are already prepared for 2 or 3 pipe systems. If you have a 3-pipe system, there's no need to make any adjustments. Just connect the liquid here, the high gas here, and the low gas here. If your memory fails you, don't worry. As you can see, all our units are labeled. Once the setting is finished, we're going to carry out the leak test. In other words, we're going to pressurize the installed system to make sure that the refrigerant piping is properly installed and that there are no leaks. Once the pressure regulator has been adjusted, connect the manifold gauge to the system. When you connect the manifold gauge to the system, you have to do the leak test. To do this, we introduce nitrogen into the system until the pressure gauge shows 41.5 bar. The test must be carried out for 48 hours to stabilize the pressures due to temperature changes and to check for any possible leaks. Once the 48 hours have passed and the results okay, we now perform the vacuum test. The vacuum test is very important. Not doing it could have serious and costly consequences for the system. If your system is a two-pipe system, we have to do it at this point and at this point. If your system is a 3-pipe system, you have to do it for these 3 pipes. This test must be run for at least 24 hours. And the optimal value for this test will be 0.76 millimeter mercury on the vacuum gauge. Once we have checked that the vacuum is satisfactory, we will charge the unit with refrigerant. For this, we will need a bottle of refrigerant, a scale, a manifold gauge, gloves, and goggles. To find out how much gas we have to charge, we should refer to the installation manual of the machine, where it explains the steps to follow to calculate the correct quantity of refrigerant. As you can see in the chart, the amount of refrigerant must be calculated using the following exact parameters. This chart is only an example, but it is important to check all the charts in the technical catalogs and service manuals, because when calculating the additional charge, you must take into account the liquid piping length, the type of indoor unit and the number of units connected, the connectivity ratio, the combination of outdoor units, CH boxes in case of a 3-pipe system. All these parameters will give you the exact amount of refrigerant you need. To start up the system correctly, it is essential to energize the system 24 hours in advance. We will need a multimeter, and in the electrical panel, we will connect the circuit breaker of the electrical panel and check that there is voltage at the terminals with the multimeter. Well, I hope this video was useful to you and you were able to solve your problem, because we are here to help you. As you know, you can always visit our YouTube channel for any other incidents, and our call center is always available for you. Greetings to all fellow installers, and remember, be professional and enjoy your work.